Alrighty, hello everybody and welcome to the October KI Live. We have a very fun and special show for all of y'all. First thing we're going to do is introduce all of these amazing people. To, I assume, your left, we've got some people sitting in a chair. I'm not sure if we're going to introduce them just yet because we have a second segment for them later on during the show. And then we also have Hocules. Introduce yourself. Also, you're muted, but Fudgeroni.
Hey, hi, hello, and howdy. My name is Hocules, also known as the Son of Zeus. I'm here to be strong, cause havoc in the world's best video game known to humankind and all alien life, and enjoy a little bit of shenanigans. Thank you so much.
Awesome. We have Leah. Hello, Leah.
Hello. I just wanted to say the chat says the audio is quiet, so let's get that turned up for, you know, Halloween time.
For obvious reasons, and Halloween.
Yes. But hi, I am Leah, Professor Falmea. I am Chief Operations Officer for KingsIsle. That means this is my circus, and y'all are my monkeys.
Yay. We also
and I have a big sword today, so I'm very happy.
I love it. I also love the few costumes that we have because, you know, Halloween. We're doing a great job. We also have Joel. Hello, Joel.
Hello. And the audio is still low, I do believe, but just our voices, I hear. The music was good. So as soon as I'm done with the intro, I'm going to go to the other room and make sure everyone actually knows that and hears it. So I'll be back.
Nice.
Oh, and then later, we're going to find out who left candy on my desk and see if they were trying to kill me or not.
Oh, that's a good point.
Okay, I'll be back.
Thanks, Joel. You're doing great. And of course, we have the sloth herself. Kaylee, go ahead.
Yes, I'm Kaylee. Today I am a sloth. I can barely see, but I do have a little sloth face. I don't know if it's showing up on camera. Like I said, I can't see really well out of this, but it's okay. The things we do for the Halloween spirit.
That's right.
But yes, by day, I am a head of marketing. So that's what I do.
Very good. And then, of course, I am Kai Icefielder, the community manager for Wizard 101. Thank you guys all for being here today for this amazing KI Live. We have a lot planned. We're going to go ahead and do a brief little overview of the topics for today. We're going to be doing, of course, the state of the games. We're going to be doing a cute little, I mean, you guys can see those incredibly talented people sitting right there. We're going to be doing a little interview with them. So stay tuned for that. And we have the marketing and community news, and then, of course, your guys' questions. I was pointing all over the place. You guys are right there. So stay tuned for all of those things. If you guys would like to be a part of the show and talk in-game, you guys can go to Realm Grey Rose Area 1 in the Commons for Wizard 101. For Pirate 101, we've got Avery's Court Area 1, of course, Skull Island. So we have a little beginning code for you guys. They're usually down at the bottom, so if you guys just check down there, you guys can see both the intro and the mid-show code. So the first code is the spooky I have no idea what's going on with the script, but spooky spiders 1023. And I'm afraid to even say what the stuff is on the code because there was a lot of changing, but I'll go ahead and say. So for Wizard 101, NANEU gets a one-day spider rider mount, and for Pirate 101, it gets a one-day giant spider mount. So super awesome. I also do see... Oh, don't worry about that. Oh, actually, that is important. So if you guys do get your question answered today during KI Live, you guys have a choice of either 2 weeks for a membership or 2.5 crowns, so 2,500 crowns. So with all that being said, of course, let's get into the really great part of the show. Professor Falmea, state of the games. And usually there's an intro. I assume it'll pop up eventually.
Also, I would like to announce to our intrepid audience, yes, we know the codes are broken.
Okay, so the codes are broken. That's okay. I was wondering why the script was moving all over the place. So thanks, guys. Yeah.
All right. Hello, hello. Hi, everybody. Happy Halloween, and welcome to a special Spooktober version of KI Live and the State of the Games. So let's start with Plunder Hunt, Pirate 101 Plunder Hunt, hot topic all around. I think there's been a lot of discussion in the Discord, so I just wanted to kind of give a little wrap up for everybody that has been paying attention to this. A few key things to mention about this new, the beginnings of this new project, because it's just the beginning. First and most importantly, this is not a full featured and polished game release, not at all. It's an early testing phase to take what we thought was a pretty fun little mobile game, arguably with too many ads, absolutely noted. I agree. To see what it looked like with pirate assets. The way that you test mobile games is to throw it up on the store. Usually it's done a little bit differently, but put it out there and just wanted to see what everybody thought. This is not the end of the road. Not even close, not by far. We want to take steps to eventually turn it into something that can be the extension of the world of Pirate 101. And we really want your feedback about how to take this or any mobile game and build something that the KI community wants to play on mobile, and we absolutely know it's not there yet. Let me say that about 10 times. We want to iterate on this game a lot more. We want to improve the gameplay, balance, mechanics, as well as delve into Pirate 101 lore eventually. So please, this is just the beginning. Also, reminder that the Pirate 101 team and the Plunder Hunt team are completely separate and independent. We're collaborating with the Gamigo team on this one. It's really actually exciting to be exploring these uncharted skyways, and hopefully we can continue going forward and eventually launching our first Spiral themed mobile game since Grub Guardian. And perhaps we can make this into something similar to Grub Guardian, which everybody seems to really love as well. I'm hoping if there are any questions in the chat, if somebody can collect them for me while I go through the rest of the State of the Games, happy to talk more about it. But I will move on, and I'm going to talk about Pirate 101, the game, the MMO, the awesomeness, as we're just closing out Pirate's Anniversary Month. It's been so awesome to see all the community feedback on Wheels Within Wheels. And it's been really cool to launch and close out 2023's third pirate update of the year by closing out the Sinbad story.
Yeah!
How about that?
Yes! Heck
yeah, pirate.
Yes. Okay. So that trash gear is fire. I really like it, but then I kind of thought, like, maybe that's dumpster fire or the opposite of dumpster fire.
The trash gear is a dumpster fire.
It's a wonderful, lovely dumpster fire. Anywho. Well, it's certainly some of the most unique equipment to put on your pirate in Spiral. So we're happy to wrap up most of the big updates for Pirate this year. And we're also very, very, very stoked about talking through internally all the places you'll go in 2024. So let's hop over to WizardEU and answer a first question of the show. As you said, email community@kingsisle.com to get your reward. And Jack asks, do you have an approximate date for when the next update will be released? And the answer is, the next EU update is definitely rounding the corner soon. We're looking to launch it before the end of the year, certainly, and the next one after that should follow on really, really quickly. We've had some pretty great progress since the last KI Live on WizardEU Steam, and we're really excited to be on Steam worldwide with both Wizard and Pirate early next year. Gosh, I cannot talk. Must have had too much candy today.
I'm rubbing off on you. I can't usually speak. Yeah. It's okay. I apologize.
I've got Kyleitis. Yeah. Ice wielder-itis. I can't talk.
Ice wielder-itis. I'm freezing you a bit. Sorry.
Okay. So lastly, I wanted to give a shout out to how awesome y'all are as a community about absolutely slaying our Extra Life fundraising goals so far. Y'all are the best. You're awesome. Better than the rest.
That's right.
Best Around, I don't know, whatever other song titles or catchy phrases I can talk about. So, wanted to ask, were there any questions that y'all have picked up before I move on?
That would be a no.
Okay, so, nextly, that does it for me, because we have Wizard US, but we have special guests that can talk a lot more cool stuff than I can. I'm going to introduce them. I'm going to do it.
Yeah, do it.
I'm gonna do it. We have Sam Johnson and Carl Hulbert. Sam, wave your hand. You've been on K-Live. You've both been on K-Live before.
I'm not sure they can hear us, but.
All right.
Sam's wearing the shorts.
Carl's wearing the awesome shirt.
Carl's wearing the cool shirt.
So for quite some time, Art has wanted us to go to Wallaru.
Of course.
And I found myself in the position of running interference because I couldn't see how to tie it to the mainline story yet. And then after Novus, I went, oh, that's why we would go to Wallaru. And so we are going to Wallaru. And Carl was overjoyed when we said,
absolutely,
we're doing it finally.
So. Well, I mean, it comes down to the fact that, I mean, when you're talking about inspiration from places like New Zealand and Australia and Tasmania, like, it's a wealth of just cool creatures, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, who doesn't want to go to Wallaru and, like, meet wallabies and kangaroos and koalas and, you know, crazy other creatures?
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think that is really, you know, why Art wanted to push so hard to get there.
And from a story standpoint also, if you look at one thing that we found challenging was, you know, looking at Australian traditional mythology, there isn't really one body of it the way that there is with other cultures.
Yeah.
And so there weren't a lot of hooks for us to grab onto, but we did a ton of research and we found lots and lots of fun myths to deal with. And then, of course, you know, like we always do, we went and looked at everything Australian that we could find. And we fought really hard to figure out how many Mad Max references we could put in there, among other things. So, but yeah, we've had a blast.
Yeah, I mean, we've really done, I mean, it was typical like movies, you know, we always try to put as many Easter eggs and fun things for cultural references in as possible, right? You know, movies, TV shows, music, and it was really cool, even like with this, I mean, Australia in like I said, that area, the Pan Pacific area, they have such like a cool, like even they even have like their own kind of cryptozoology,
mm-hmm.
right? I mean, you know, we are used to like Bigfoot and, you know, the Loch Ness Monster, you know, but they have like the Bunyip. I mean, mm-hmm. there's some in drop bears. I mean, there's really cool things that are there to pull from. So we're really excited about it.
Yeah, it's we were worried, especially coming off of Novus, that it was going to feel too normal, but we found the weirdness and we brought it out. So we've been very, very pleased with the results.
Yeah.
And what was the hardest part?
I would say that, I mean, honestly, when we were talking about it from Art, you know, we kind of got there was a little bit of a kerfuffle when we did Lemuria, where people believed that, you know, the beginning of Lemuria was just Aztec kind of like rehash, which was totally not true. There were definitely parts that purposely in Lemuria were reused and kind of reworked. But the beginning was completely original. So ever since then, we've been fighting this kind of like, oh, well, you guys are lazy. You just reuse stuff. And, you know, it couldn't be further from the truth. Now, that being said, yeah, bits of Australia look like a bits of the American Southwest. There's orange dirt. There's trees. You know, there's lots of places in the world where there are orange dirt and trees. And specifically, one of the things that we wanted to do with the time frame on the Art side was we wanted to capture kind of the magic of that kind of pioneering era of Australia, right? So we set things very much at the, you know, turn of like late 19th, early 20th century Australia.
That wild frontier.
Yep.
Yeah.
So there'll be tones of what players might recognize as the American West. But in no way did we reuse, you know, kind of anything really from Cool Ranch. You know, we didn't really do any of that. Everything was pretty much from scratch. Maybe a couple little things here and there, like maybe a texture of a bush or something. But for the most part, things are all new.
Well, and we looked to find the very different stuff.
Yes.
We wanted to use the barrier reef. And we were trying to figure out for the longest time how to bring that in there. And we finally figured out how to do it in a very strange way. But for instance, if you look up what eucalyptus trees look like, they look really weird. Cool. And we have a whole forest of them, and it's going to be fantastic.
Rainbow bark.
Yeah, rainbow bark. So we have a sneak preview, a special sneak preview today.
Absolutely. So for the first time ever, the art department kind of has been busting its butt. And we really wanted to get something to show you all special today. So for the first time out there, and granted, this is still a work in progress. We're not even to test realm yet. So we are going to be happy to show you our current progress on the Wallaru spells, all seven of them. So I really hope you enjoy them and enjoy this sneak peek. Here you go. So hopefully you all enjoyed that, and it gets you talking and thinking about how all the cool stuff that's going to happen in Wallaru. And again, I would like to thank the sound team, my FX guys, character artists, animators, all the people that have been involved in the spells, and brought it to you here today.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, and hope you all enjoyed it. Pass it off to the next people.
One final note with regards to story stuff in particular. Unlike recent years, due to community feedback, these spells will be attached to spell quests. Yay. So there will be lore associated with them, and you will learn a thing or two about Australia, a thing or two about Xander, a thing or two about everything. So anyway, there you go.
Very good. Well, we had a wonderful talk here. I wanted to be more part of it, but we have things happening all over the place here. Is there anything else that you wanted to say in the beginning? Well, we had some volume issues, so.
We're okay. We got
everything in, talked about it. We're going to have these guys on. You're going to come back again for, I'm sure, the next KI Live. Yeah. We're going to have special test realm events as well, probably a live stream in there too, and maybe some other special things to give you a chance to talk about it more.
And if the players want to hear more about, art and story, all means, let Matthew know, and we'll come back.
Yeah, we have the test realm Discord already prepped and ready to go. Sweet. A little bit more on that soon. And then once test realm actually begins, we'll get your feedback. And if you have questions, follow-ups from KI Live here today during test realm and everything else, we will be monitoring for those, and we'll answer those on future events. All right. Thank you very much, guys. Back to everybody else.
See you soon.
Bye, everybody.
That was a really interesting segment with Wallaru, and I hope you guys really enjoyed it. It's around the corner, y'all. So get ready. Wallaru's almost here. So I guess we can continue on with the show, right? Everything's fixed now. Good to go. Okay. So, Kaylee, good luck. It's your turn now. Talk about some marketing stuff.
Fantastic.
We have a question for you.
Okay.
This question is from Charles H. What are you handing out to trick-or-treaters this year?
Well, I wouldn't say that's a marketing question, but I can surely
it's definitely
answer
not.
It. I am handing out the good stuff this Halloween. I love chocolate, and I always hated when people gave out like the gummy stuff. Like, I know some people like gummy candies. That's not me. I like the, you know, Three Musketeers, Hershey's, Reese's, and so I'm giving out those brand name chocolates. So we'll see how many people come by. I will be wearing the same outfit when I answer the door. So I'm hoping people
good.
Like my sloth onesie. As
nice.
Far as marketing news, not a lot I can share this month because a lot of things are happening, but behind the scenes that are not ready to be announced. But really well done on the Bartleby plushie. That is our fourth most popular plushie ever in terms of units sold. And that was a jumbo. So it also not only was big, but it also was much more expensive than the classic regular plushies. So y'all really liked the Bartleby plushie. That's one of our favorites. I loved the schools going around at the bottom of him. And then his eye also is removable. So
it
seemed like y'all loved that too. And we love that. Chris mentioned earlier there is an El Toro plushie for sale right now, so make sure to pick him up before you can't anymore. I've been told that he's been memeified. He is a chonky boy, I will admit. but he's
That's
a
great.
Lovable chonky boy. And we love El Toro. He's one of my favorite companions. So
yeah.
Very short marketing update this time, but I feel like there's been a lot of interesting entertainment this KI Live that can make up for it.
And like you said, there is a lot more going on behind the scenes, so that just
mm-hmm.
means there's going to be a lot to share later on.
Exactly.
And that's very exciting. Okay, so thank you, Kaylee. Now we've got some community news. I don't know, Chris, Hocules, if you'd like to talk about the community news.
I'd love to talk about the community news. Y'all can hear me, right?
I can definitely.
Oh, thank goodness. Thank you to everyone that's participating in extra credits. Y'all are legends and scholars. We've got some fantastic new folks. I'm going to list some out in no particular order. Here we go. Dereal Almond, Glad Rocker, The Frenzy Gamer, Valencian Pirate, Ellipses, and many more. Thank you all so much. We have monthly chats with the extra credits folks, and they make some content that honestly makes me envious, green with envy. Y'all are talented. And it makes me upsetty spaghetti. Objective 6 concludes tomorrow. The next objective for the extra credits participants will be to make a to make a collaboration video on any gameplay topic, as long as you're working together. It's about collaboration. You can have in-game assistance for someone random or actual video production work, aka here's how to make good content. Please make some of those. Some of y'all are very talented, and I want to learn from you. Thanks
right.
to all the extra credits, folks. Some people are asking, when are new people being added to the program? We added a few just a couple of weeks ago. If you didn't get accepted, fear not. More rounds of invitations will happen. No, we're not making an 18-plus creators program. Everything we do is family-friendly.
Everything that we do is family-friendly.
The whole thing. Thank you all so much that's participating in extra credits. And if you are watching 101 Spiral related content, please continue to do so. You're doing great. Give it a like. Unless
thanks,
they're being
everybody.
Stinky, then don't.
Oh yeah, no stinky. That's not good. But yeah, thank you everybody. I do see a segment here that we're probably not going to do, but we have a mid-show gift code, which again, I'm going to mention with the codes. I think the codes are broken, so we will be leaving them on longer than usual so you guys can grab a code once we fix it. So for the mid-show giveaway, it is Super Fans 10:23. Again, they're all scrolling at the bottom. Yes, they are broken, but they will be unbroken soon. For this code, you'll be getting one Super Terrorist Horde Pack in Wizard 101 for NA and EU, one Super Pirate Nightmare Pack in Pirate 101. Of course, you'll be getting one KI Live Snack Pack in Wizard 101 NA and Pirate 101. You can see Strunk from Hockules. Thank you. And then, of course, you'll be getting one Superfan Outfit piece per game. So I assume that's Wizard Pirate. And all right, those are all of the amazing topics. Now we have, of course, the community questions for you guys. Again, if you guys get your question answered, you guys have a choice of getting a 2-month membership or 2,500 crowns. So we have some warm-up questions. Anybody in this little chat can answer. This is a question from Charles. Do you have any fond Halloween stories you can share with us? Anybody? I know Leah definitely has an answer there.
Like family-friendly stories?
Yes,
specifically those.
Yeah.
Okay. So I couldn't really think of much because the time Halloween for us on the game team is like, yes, Halloween is cool, but man, we're like sprinting towards the next world almost every year, so it's kind of like a blur. But all the Halloween KI lives are pretty cool. Like, it's one of my favorite ones of the year. This one might go down in the record as some of the most chaotic ever, but
that's a great point. Yeah,
they're usually some of my favorite. So that's what I got.
I have a very infamous Halloween story.
Okay.
Who were working at KingsIsle that year will probably remember that in 2019, I dressed up as a crash test dummy and it shared on the KingsIsle socials, so you can go back and see it. But later that same night that I won the Halloween company costume contest, I was going to meet up with a friend and we were going to like go and hang out and celebrate spooky things. And I actually wrecked my car in a parking lot. So it was very ironic that I dressed up as a crash test dummy and then ruined my car that same night. And it is forever in my memory and my friend's memory. And yep, that is definitely my most memorable Halloween story. And I still went and hung out after that. That didn't stop me. My mom was like, Kaylee, you went out after you wrecked your car? I'm like, I just hit a little pole on the side. You know, it was still worth going out for, and I handled it the next day, so it was fine.
I could use a yum yum juice right now, so.
That's my
But
story.
Yeah, that is really funny. I don't even know if I have any funny Halloween stories or anything that I find. I don't know. I guess I kind of agree with Leah. Like, I really do enjoy the KLIs for October, and just dressing up in general is really fun, but nothing really too crazy.
I Halloween many years ago was at a KI Halloween party, and there was a person dressed up in a bear costume, and I was like, "Ooh, this will be fun. We'll pretend to wrestle," like not wrestle, but like, you know, to get a good picture. And the railing at this place fell down, and I fell off the back of the railing, landed on my knee, and broke it in three places.
Oh my goodness!
So that's a very memorable Halloween for me. I broke my leg fighting a bear.
I feel that. That's my story about my my broken foot story. It actually is not that, but that's what I tell people. The other one is too embarrassing. Anyway, so we are running slightly shorter on time because of all the cute little shenanigans. So I'm going to go ahead and move on to some pirate questions for you guys.
Oh, I just said let's roll.
Oh, let's do it.
Let's do it.
All right, the next question we have, and I think I'll just do this one that's for any. Player Game 789, love your name. Happy 11th birthday to Pirate 101. Happy 11th birthday. You guys are doing a really great job. What is your favorite memory in these past 11 years of Pirate 101? Oh my gosh, that's a really good question. Anybody can start first.
Happy 11th birthday, everybody. So recently, a new favorite memory was just watching the new influx of pirates and returning pirates since we launched on Steam and started updating. So, like, I mean, there's a lot of good stuff that happened before, but that's my favorite now. And I have an answer from Sam, who has departed. Sam says it would have to be when the first expansion went live in May 2013, watching the community react to Marleybone and Aquila. I bet that was cool. That would have been awesome. I was not really part of that at that point, but that was a huge expansion. So what do y'all think?
I have a favorite memory, but more from pre-launch, like during development. We had an intern that was helping do the UI with the me and Rusty, who were doing the UI at the time. And he was super smart. He ended up going back to college and finishing his degree. And since then, he's made like 3 award-winning indie games. And aww, like, it was so cool to be able to work with him when he was still like a student. And but then for actual like pirate things, that like my most memorable things, probably the feedback about the bee buffaloons, I can't think of their name off the top of my head right now, in Cool Ranch when people first got there in beta, because I don't know if anyone remembers how incredibly difficult it was.
They don't need to remember. They're still having a rough time. The bumbaloons will mess you up. That's that difficulty spike.
That difficulty spike was meant to be a group thing at that point. Like, you couldn't pass it without a group. But now it's, you know, a little bit easier.
I love
seeing people get to that spot and just like, rah! But then they figure it out.
I love that. I would definitely, and mine's a little bit sentimental. It was convenient that you showed that cute little picture. Honestly, I love Pirate, almost everything about it. But I think my favorite moment in Pirate history is when Hockules was onboarded. It was one of my favorite moments because that was when I met that beautiful man, and he has done such a great job, including the entire pirate team. But Hockules, you're doing great.
I love you so much. Why am I crying on the KI live?
Can we feel the love?
Yay.
Feel the love. Yay.
The wedding already happened, Jason.
Yeah. It was on an island.
The work wedding. We're not actually married.
Yeah.
Y'all okay. Worked and went together? Yeah. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty.
The question. Haley?
Yeah, let's look at another question. Okay, this is another question from Ari. What is / was your favorite piece of art, character design, music, or voice line from Sinbad Part Chapter 3? I'll be honest, I'm not too sure. However, I do love the idea of having Rook, like that design of Rook, but he's back, right? He's back, right? Like, I think that is so insane, and I love it.
I have another Sam answer here, and I agree with it. Sam says, I'm very fond of Bonnie Anne's triumphant return.
And yes!
It'll be for me, so yeah. I'm a big Bonnie Anne fan, so I'll go with that one. Also, that trash gear. I don't know. It just makes me laugh. Like, the stop sign, the sandwich. I know that's not a VO line or anything, but it is part of the update, so... Just carrying around a sandwich. I don't know. It just makes me laugh.
Carrying a sandwich.
Anyone else, or should we move on? All right.
All righty. All right. We've got some Wizard 101 EU questions. So for the first one is from DizX Matiaka. I'm hoping I'm saying that right. I doubt I am. When will it be possible to transfer characters on EU websites?
So I'll take this one. No character transfer plans to announce right now, but we do hear you. We understand the interest, and it is possible in the longer term future. It sounds super simple to do. We get this question all the time because it's like, oh, why don't you just do that? If we could, we would, believe me. It is a lot more complicated. Our account structure is super fun, and it's a lot more complicated than you'd imagine. So heard, understood, something that could happen in the future, but we got to sort through some other stuff first.
Got it. All right.
Hoculies says hi, chat.
Hoculies says hi, chat. This question, it doesn't look like it has a person. Okay. No, that's okay. Do you want me to read the question?
There is the question of, are we going to add the Azoth promo codes once guilds are released in the EU, similar to the Novus teaser codes that were included the free Azoth when that launched there? And my response is, yes, we can do that. Yes, we will probably do that. Yes, remind me again before we launch.
Yes.
I have it on my plan. The next one was me too. And it says, some mounts from the US of the Caramel and Lemuria area weren't added to the Crown Shop yet, like the Chocolate Moose and the Cyber Rex. Will they be added someday? And my answer is yes. Keely's in control of Chocolate Moose, so you have to bribe her. But most likely that's in December. And then the Cyber Rex, probably in the next 2-3 months. I'm trying to make sure I don't dump all the new things at you all at once and try to just kind of space it out. Otherwise, nothing gets its moment to shine. We've done so many updates so quickly for Wizard EU to get you up to speed, and we're getting even closer now, that each thing needs a day or two of its own. But I want to go back to the question Leah answered also about the character transfer stuff. So that is something that we are looking into. It's going to be a lot of work. It's going to take some people offline to do other things for a while once we start the process of doing that. And we need to make sure that it is worth the time and effort of taking that person off at the time that we have to take them off of their normal work. It's not an easy thing at all. And it's a little bit of a pain, but I will tell you that we have started looking into seeing how long and how much effort each part of it will take.
Very okay, nice.
I'm done.
All righty, I love it.
Chocolate Moose Squad.
You have to release it from your vault. I know you have a vault filled with different kinds of mooses from the game.
Oh my gosh. Any and all types of moose. They are my favorite.
Kaylee? moose onesie when?
I already have one, Leah. I could totally bring it out any day.
The way that he was like, what do you mean? I already have one.
December KI Live. I want to see that. We should have a one.
That actually will work because the moose onesie I have is Christmas themed. It has jingle bells on it. So
I'm writing this down, Kaylee. This okay. has to
Please
happen.
Please hold me to it.
December KI Live. Everybody, even out here in chat, wear your onesies.
Oh gosh. Okay.
Okay, we're planning live on the show. What do y'all think? Yep, I see do it on it. We love onesies.
I love them. They're so comfy.
I don't have one. Xander, get one. It's just warm and comfy.
Or convince someone else to get you one.
Yeah, that's true. Just get it as an early Christmas gift or
exactly
holiday gift.
And then just tell them it's for KI Live. And then when they're like, what do you mean? Just be like, don't ask so many questions. Just give me a onesie.
Froggy onesie? Oh, that would be the best. Wearable blanket, we'll give you a pass. Yeah.
All
okay.
right.
That's fine. Okay. Sorry.
All right.
Move on along.
All right. Let's do it. So, Wizard 101, folks, wizards, chime in because obviously we've got something around the corner and a lot of these questions have to do with that. So, these are a lot of answers from Sam. I don't know if Sam can jump on to that, might be a lot of work. So, we'll see, but
I'll do my best impression.
Okay, cool. So this question is from Destiny Ghost Song. It's a very long one, but are the different areas in Wallaru going to be all desert, or will there be any other landscapes that are common in Australia? There's more to that. Also, what types of animals will be shown, seeing as there are so many kinds?
There will be a wide variety of environments. Australia is far more than just arid scrub. We drew inspiration from all over, even the Barrier Reef. As to the animals, We stick with the greatest hits, mostly mammals, though there is also a lovely fish.
I love what? That.
Did that work?
That was really great, actually.
Keep,
I think what, I was
I'll keep pretending
watching.
I'll
oh,
like
gosh.
It.
Okay, good. You are now Sam. Okay, this question is from Stormcloud. What is your favorite line of Wallaru dialogue?
I love this. I'm actually going to change his answer. I could tell you, but that would be telling.
Ooh, that was good. I liked that. That was different.
He didn't actually give you one, mm-hmm. So you'll have to wait.
No, yeah, you didn't get one. I have plenty, yeah. But ask that question again when it's released.
Yes.
Okay, this question is from Alexander Smith. Will there be any return... Oh, I'm sorry. Any returning characters from previous worlds in Wallaru besides Prospector Zeke, of course, and oh my goodness. Go ahead and answer.
Yes. We've already given San Diego away, and there's a pretty
there it is.
Obvious returning cameo, I bet y'all can guess. But there will
Don't
be-
forget Eloise.
Yeah, wait a minute. Prospector Zeke and Eloise. We love
that. Just waiting for that Twitter account that has her screaming in caps on her cell phone all day.
Oh my gosh.
It's the best. That is the best.
All righty.
Eloise on her iPhone.
Are you in chat? No, I'm kidding. Okay. Another question.
Kid friendly Twitter, so be careful going to that one.
That's a great point. Tiffany Wintertail, what is the most challenging part of making the Wallaru world?
What is the most challenging part of making the Wallaru? Sorry. Oh, I missed a question. Balancing the needs of the world with the needs of the Ark and making sure our depictions of Australian mythology were handled with sensitivity. Indeed.
I love it. Indeed. Very nice. Very nice. I hope you guys aren't getting too distracted because you better grab them. No. And our final question is from Zorg. I don't know who wants to voice Greg. He did just run away from me. He scared me.
Aww.
Not 10, 20 minutes ago. Are there any new Monstrology updates in the works? He is watching KA Live. Where's Greg? He could get over here. Oh.
Oh.
That's all right.
You're not going to get him? Okay. I'll do it again. Yes!
I think I saw Waldo behind you a
second
ago. Excited.
I know. I found Waldo.
Greg is like the friendliest, smiliest guy.
Oh, here comes Greg. Wait, Greg, answer this question.
Okay, cool.
Woohoo, it's Greg.
Hi, I think this is my first time on this program. Hello, everyone. So right now we're mainly focused on getting all the respected Monstrology set up for Wallaru. So everything should be there as soon as like even test realm drops. And we're also looking forward to further improvements and bug fixes that will hopefully happen throughout the rest of Test Realm. And thank you. And we're also looking into further additions into the system especially throughout the rest of the next year. All right.
Thanks, Greg. You did great. Also, you scared me earlier. How dare. No, you're fine. Okay. Well, that is our last question, and that was a really good end of the show. You guys got to meet a really great designer, Greg Miller. He also has a Twitter. We've retweeted some of his stuff before. If he ever tweets anything else again, we're definitely going to retweet it because he has some really cute stuff. Give him a follow. He's great. But other than that, thank you guys so much for this very chaotic and very entertaining KA Live for October. I think that's all. I'm going to wrap it up. You guys have a really great weekend. Have a happy Halloween. Be safe. Enjoy your candy. Bye, everybody.
Thanks, everyone. Bye. Have a good time.
Have a good time.
Happy Halloween.
Go be.